65-year-old woman. Sergio Jose Martinez was taken into custody Monday night. He is also charged with attacking another woman who fought him off. Local authorities released Martinez from custody last year despite a request from federal authorities to notify them beforehand. Portland is a sanctuary city. Now residents of one Washington town are pushing for a vote on their sanctuary city policy. This comes as a 23-year-old illegal immigrant sits in jail there tonight, accused of a heinous crime. Correspondent Dan Springer tells us about it from Seattle.
On the night of June 25th at this apartment building in Burien, Washington, just outside Seattle, a 19-year-old woman was savagely beaten and raped. According to the probable cause document, when she stumbled home, she had a bloody head, missing teeth, upper lip was torn, ear was torn and dangling, and was only wearing her tank top. 4 days later, after viewing surveillance video and recovering his blood-soaked pants, police arrested their suspect at the apartment complex next door. He's 23-year-old Salvador Diaz Garcia. Fox News has learned he's an illegal immigrant. ICE first confirmed to Fox News that Garcia passed a background check in 2013 and was given DACA status, deferred action on childhood arrivals. The so-called dreamer was renewed twice, most recently on January 31st, just after Burien became a sanctuary city. Now there's an effort to repeal the law. It's led by Craig Keller, who says the young victim was not helped by immigrants' willingness to come forward.
She was beat unconscious in her apartment's physical fitness room and then raped. It was not an illegal alien that reported that person.
The Burien City Council is bitterly divided. Sanctuary City supporters, including candidate Crystal Marks, say the attack is not an indictment of the policy.
If it were the case that all people undocumented were committing these crimes, we would have a much higher number, but we don't. So we need to look at the facts and not let our emotions guide us on this.
But opponents argue giving sanctuary to illegals makes citizens less safe.
You want to lean toward having this welcoming, we want everybody here to be happy and feel safe. How can we guarantee that if we don't know anything about people living in our midst?
Salvador Garcia is being held on a $350,000 bail. Yesterday, his dreamer status was revoked. In November, the voters of Burien could become the first in the nation